Here we have verse 14 of the 8th chapter of the Gospel of John. Jesus is confronting the religious leaders. They're trying to trip him up with regard to the technical requirements of the law. They've basically challenged him at the point of his credibility because he bears witness, as they say, to himself. But lacking a second corroborating witness, they would draw the conclusion that his witness is therefore not true. Jesus, of course, appeals to his own perfect knowledge of his own situation, his own identity, his own origins, and his own destiny. And so that becomes, in a sense, an absolute defense. He himself, knows the truth of it, and knows all of the background behind it. But the response he gives here is more or less an assertion of that very fact, as we have apokrithei. This is the aorist of the verb apokrinomai, deponent verb, passive in form, active in meaning, third person singular, aorist active indicative, apokrithei. He answered, Jesus, the subject of the verb, he answered, kai apen, kai the connective, and apen from lego, I say, third person singular, aorist active indicative, autois, to them, said to them, the dative plural masculine, kai, or con, really, conjunction of a couple of words. It means even though, or though, something like that, usually is the way it's rendered, even though, ego. The presence of the pronoun here suggesting emphasis, so even though I, with emphasis on it, marturo. For martureo, contract verb, present active indicative, first person singular. So even though I bear witness, I testify, peri, preposition, takes the genitive, concerning, hemautu, first person reflexive pronoun, I bear witness concerning myself, he says, aletheis, adjective, this is nominative, singular, feminine, because it's going with marturia, which is feminine. So true, esten, it is, from a me, I am, third person singular, present active indicative. True is, hey, the marturia witness. Again, marturia is related to marturo. One, the former is first word here is a verb, marturao. This is a noun, otherwise the same word, the root of our word martyr, but at this point in time it simply meant a witness, especially someone who would testify in court. So true is the witness mu of me, enclitic pronoun, genitive singular. And then he continues, hoti, because oida, first person singular, perfect active indicative, I know, I knew and continue to know is the sense of it. Pothen, whence, as in the sense of from where. Aelthon, from erkamai, I come or I go. This is the first person singular, aorist active indicative, second aorist verb. So I know whence I came, kai, and pu, the indeclinable adverb means where, and where hupago I go, as in going away. So I happen to know by first-hand knowledge, by indisputable confidence in my own knowledge, I know whence I came and where I go. Humes, then, again emphatic, standing in contrast to ego up here, humes, you, second person, pronoun, nominative, plural, so you, da, but you, soft conjunction, uk oidata, same word that we saw earlier, this is oida, this is oidata, second person, plural, perfect active indicative, you did not know and continue not to know, pothen, same word, whence, erkomai, I come, this is now taking the word aelthon that we had here, putting it back into the present, so first person singular present active indicative, you do not know whence I come, a, or the conjunction pu, same as here, where, hupago, I go. I know this, you don't know this. Jesus has perfect knowledge of his own situation, his own destiny, his own meaning, his own purpose and mission. These people do not. And that in itself is sufficient to give weight to his own self-acclamation. He knows these things of himself, with or without some kind of a testing witness. Of course, Jesus has attesting witnesses. He has the imprimatur of heaven itself. He has signs and wonders that he's performed, which give irrefutable proof of the fact that God is with him. But aside from that, his own affirmation of his own knowledge is sufficient to meet the challenge that's being raised to him by these who are trying to discredit him, trying to cause him to lose face in the sight of the crowds.